Vinyl carried her alcohol with roughly the same precision that she carried herself while under its influence. In essence, not very well at all. A hoof full of Stagner's bottles later, she devolved into a barely coherent mass of stumbling limbs and slurred speech. While it had crossed the minorly tipsy Octavia's mind to simply let her walk home and maybe watch at a distance with a box of popcorn, she decided it was for the better to help her somewhere safe where she could allow her liver to slog its way through the backlog of alcohol in her system. Thankfully, Vinyl's choice in the wine bar for the night had placed them within reasonable distance of Octavia's apartment. So Octavia had opted to take her home, not that Vinyl was anywhere near capable of conveying a yay or nay on that question. It was due to this turn of events that Octavia found herself half-propping, half-dragging Vinyl to her home. In essence, she had become a bona fide crutch, and admittedly, her alcohol intake for the evening had somewhat affected her balance as well. Fortunately, the fresh air was doing something to keep her lucid as she helped Vinyl along as best as she could. So, in all honesty, the pair fell down into a chaotic pile of legs and hair quite a few times. Still, Octavia felt it better than lingering in the bar. She hoped that their absence would lead the ice cream pony to write about something less vulgar, or at the very least, something that didn't involve her. Octavia wrapped a foreleg around Vinyl, shunting the groaning mare onto her hooves. Only a few more blocks now. They passed by a public house, the bar itself packed to the brim with yobs enjoying their hoofball games. An incredibly overrated and cultureless pastime, in Octavia's opinion. Hoof a ball in a box. Doesn't take any skill or thought at all. It seemed that the game had recently ended, because as they passed by the bar, a trio of cheering and heavily intoxicated colts burst out, chorusing a hoofball chant. It was this that roused the barely conscious Vinyl to lift her head and foreleg, waving at the colt with a cry of,
"Green Army!"
Octavia snapped Vinyl's hoof to the floor, hissing in her ear.
"Vinyl, stop it! The last thing I want is a group of drunk colts to know we're a pair of barely sober fillies out on our own."
"What's wrong, Octavia?"
Vinyl tried and failed to keep her head at Octavia's eye level.
"Scared of a little male attention?"
"Ugh. Like I'd want to spend the night with a drunken hooligan like them."
Vinyl giggled, though she'd surrendered to the alcohol and was now staring down at the floor.
"So instead you're taking a drunken filly hooligan for the night?"
"Well, I would hardly treat you the same way one does a colt, and to be honest, you're mostly harmless anyway."
Vinyl reared up on her hind legs, blind luck and a southwesterly wind the only things keeping her upright.
"Harmless? I could bust your rump easy as pie, Octavia. Like apple pie. You got any apple pie at home?"
"I might. The real question is whether I'd give you any."
"If you do, I won't beat you up. I promise."
"Truly, Vinyl, you are a gentlemare."
After much struggling and more passive threats concerning Vinyl's wish for food, Octavia finally managed to drag the filly to her home. A simple night on the couch, then she would turf her out in the morning. She left Vinyl to lean against the wall, took out her keys, opened the door, then picked up Vinyl after she inevitably fell over again. Octavia felt that tonight would be a good thing to jot on her CV, in case she ever took a job in the Merfia. In honesty, she had the body-dragging experience in the cello case now. She was probably as qualified as they come. Vinyl was placed rather unceremoniously on the couch. She then proceeded to de-ceremony herself as much as ponily possible by slumping into a sprawling position over the soft suede surface. Irritatingly, she remained awake while Octavia opened her favorite cupboard. Naturally, contained within it was a plethora of beverages, but it was the prized Jura she extracted, tipping it into a glass and enjoying a refreshing sip as she reclined in her own chair. Vinyl had been watching her, while Octavia had noted the fact she was slowly slipping off the couch, but didn't feel any pressing need to help. Vinyl once more that night found herself face down on the floor, her legs flailing a second after she landed. Octavia could only take it for a massively delayed attempt to stay on the couch. She watched Vinyl's sluggish attempts to claw her way back onto the couch, sipping the Jura. In the end, she felt it necessary to help her, if only to stay her scuffing the suede with her hooves.
"Come here, you."
She once more slipped her forelegs under Vinyl's form, and raised her onto the couch, repositioning her limbs to be more stable this time.
"Thanks, Octi. You got any music? Can't sleep without music."
"I suppose a light piece of Mozart can help any pony to sleep."
"You put that classical junk on, and I'll snap the Vinyl it's recorded on, okay?"
Vinyl peeped open an eye. A playful, malicious glint was visible on its surface. The tips of her lips curled upwards in a light smile.
"Got anything more my kind of thing?"
Octavia basically couldn't be bothered with the hassle of a musical argument at that point, and she doubted Vinyl's brain was receptive enough to acknowledge it anyway. She rifled through her collection of records, calling out anything that might have pleased the paralytic unicorn mare.
"Bruce Wingsheen?"
Oh no, not an apple and western. Bin it if you wanna.
Octavia growled under her breath. The vocals in that album were particularly well sung.
Blink Sinatra?
Ugh, boring. So slow.
You really are impossible.
She pulled out a cover, lightly coated in dust.
I suppose Winnie Hendrix is too old for your tastes, too.
You have Hendrix?
Vinyl gasped, but not in spiteful glee as Octavia imagined she would. No, this was genuine glee.
You like him?
What sane pony doesn't? Sure, new bands like Hedge Sevenfold and Atreyu are a little bit punchier, but you can't beat the old classics.
Vinyl was a little more upright, clapping her hooves together with joy. Octavia slipped the vinyl onto the plate, eager for anything other than the noise of vinyl ridiculing bands she quite enjoyed. She did enjoy Hendrix, the guitar was skillfully played, and it was definitely more pronounced and thought out than most of the screaming noise that passed for metal these days. It wasn't a musician she often sought out, but thankfully one she would happily listen to if it happened to be playing, this occasion being one such instance of that. She stood back from the record player, the music beginning to filter through. The sound of clinking glasses alerted her to Vinyl's movements, and she found the house guest rifling her way through the drinks cupboard with her magic.
Do feel free to make yourself at home, Vinyl.
No problem. Say, you never said you had this stuff.
She retrieved a bottle of a rich green liquor. Pan Equestrian Gargle Blasters. All the power of an alicorn, distilled into alcohol and served up in a bottle.
Vinyl, how are you so lively all of a sudden anyway?
Come on, Winnie could get any pony moving. What did you buy this stuff for if you're not going to drink it anyway?
Vinyl poured out two glasses and a small puddle on the carpet. It's not really easy to tell whether the carpet enjoyed the drink. The green color the usually cream fibers took up may have just been a quinopomorphized sickness, or it may have just been the color of the liquor, in all honesty. Octavia took the offered drink, that had in turn been unspokenly unoffered to Vinyl. She had tried them before. Once. The hangover was brutal, and she felt little need to drink it more often. However, there was something about the way Vinyl gleefully offered the drinks with that filly-like glint in her eyes that put Octavia at ease. She carefully sniffed the drink, remembering the not-so-delicate allure of paint thinner on its scent. Vinyl sniffed her own, her snout wrinkling at the smell.
That'll put you into an early retirement. All right. 3, 2, 1, slug.
The pair downed the drinks. Octavia felt her world instantly get pounded 6 ways from Sunday in an instant. It became suddenly very difficult to orchestrate the myriad of leg muscles required to keep upright, and she plummeted to the floor in a barely conscious alcoholic haze. As was previously mentioned, Octavia was no stranger to awakening in the realm of the hangover. What she had yet to grow used to was the various fiefdoms of a hangover, and the condition she'd been left in upon visiting one. It must be said that she had never awoken upside down on her own couch before. Octavia was genuinely unaware whether the pounding in her head was the alcohol permeating her blood, or the blood itself collecting in her head. Her head lolled over the edge of the couch in as graceless a way as she could be imagined. She shifted her body, trying to at least get the ceiling to go back to where it belonged and return its space to the floor. This turned out to be more difficult than she had imagined, as her drunken self had apparently managed to delicately balance herself in this precarious position. A balance that was lightly stolen away as she moved, and fell headfirst onto the carpet, the rest of her body joining its leader in a crumpled mass above it. At least the blood was beginning to even itself out now, but if anything, the rapid drain of blood had made her headache worse. She managed to collect and sort her body in a manner she imagined would be fitting, the carpet being lumpier than she had remembered. She felt a sharp cylindrical edge and a pointed cone poking into her back. The very irritated but surprisingly well-camouflaged pony shunted her off with a pained groan, and Octavia got to feel the soaring joy of a Pegasus for the briefest of moments before she once more landed on the carpet with a loud thud.
Like my head wasn't bad enough without your rump falling onto it.
I can hardly be blamed. I'm not letting you near me with that stuff ever again.
Vinyl rolled over, her crimson irises surrounded by an equally crimson array of tiny blood vessels, hardly presenting a well-maintained window to her soul.
Why do you even have that stuff? It's not natural.
I got bored one day. Shoot me.
Octavia rolled over to face Vinyl, and she could see in her reflection on the nearby mirror, that was hanging from the wall but fortunately still intact, that her eyes were equally ravaged by the swarming capillaries.
You want a drink?
Yeah, my throat's killing me. Wait.
Vinyl reached around her neck, noticing an adornment she wasn't familiar with. Her magic sluggishly attempted to grip it, almost choking her a few times, until she pulled it off. In the glowing white aura before her was a little pink bow tie.
Why the hey am I wearing your bow tie?
Oh, I don't know. Honestly, I'm far too tired to even consider what happened.
Octavia clamped her hooves to her head in an attempt to counteract the pounding pulse of her headache by squeezing it into submission. It was surprisingly comforting, her hooves being a lot softer than she remembered. Almost like cashmere? She pulled away her hooves, noticing the pink clothing wrapped around her calves, tiny gray clefts adorned on each one. The blood once more returned to her head, congregating in her cheeks as if to laugh at her embarrassment. She ripped the socks off of her hooves, stowing them under the couch before returning to see Vinyl's grin breaking through her pain.
Nice socks, Octavia. Now, do you mind explaining this?
Vinyl smoothed back the coat on her neck, revealing an inflamed, bruise-like mark.
'Cause I looked in the mirror, and it looks like teeth marks.
Octavia's mind was slowly grinding to a halt, not really capable of processing the situation before her.
Maybe a dog?
Do you even have a dog?
No. You could have simply fallen over.
No, these are definitely teeth. And it looks like a pony's. I don't know. What do you think?
Vinyl stared at Octavia blankly, who, with nothing to go on, fell upon that ancient fallback devised by an ingenious social embarrassment fallback inventor many years ago.
I think we need a nice cup of tea.
Octavia rose as rapidly as her aching limbs could carry her, galloping past Vinyl and into the kitchen. Vinyl watched her pass, giggling despite the pain the movements caused to her head. She reached towards the record player that was still bleeding the same incessant tune she didn't recognize. She picked up the vinyl, her face somehow finding a shade whiter than its own natural tone as she recognized the artist, Bridal White, before tossing it under the couch to rest quietly next to the tabooed socks. This was definitely a night both of them would be glad that neither could remember.